is a short introduction to the graph editor in Stata. The graph editor allows you to edit graphs with a point and click interface. All edits using commands can also be done with this interface, and there are also some extra tools available. These tools are shown here and include the ability to add text and draw lines, circles, and arrows in non-telegraphed positions, so you can put them anywhere on the graph. To start the graph editor, you first create a graph and then click the graph editor button. An example of a graph edited in this way is shown here along with the steps used. And here we illustrate that example. So to begin with, we're going to load the NLSW88 example Stata dataset, and we're going to graph the mean of wage over industry as a bar graph. And once that graph pops up, we click the graph editor button, which looks like a bar chart with a pencil over the top, and then we start to apply our edits. Now you can't see it here, but I am double clicking on the elements in the actual graph itself. I'm not using the right hand side menu, even though that is lighting up as I select different things. You can do it either way. You can select elements from the right hand side menu, or you can select them directly within the graph. I find it much easier just to pick up what I want clicking on the graph. I find it more intuitive that way. So here I am changing the axis labels to 45 degree angle and making them smaller so they're legible. Before they were all bunched up together. I've got rid of the blue background and I've changed the grid lines to just a straight black line so that they match better. And I'm changing the color of the bars to purple. And we have our graph. The graph editor also allows you to record edits that you make, and you can apply the recording to any subsequent graph. If you apply it to a different type of graph, some of the elements might not match up, so those won't be applied. And here is an example that showcases the use of the graph recorder. So we load up our graph and we open the graph editor, and then we click on the red circle to start the recording and we apply our edits as before. So we're applying all of the same edits, selecting the things that we want to change and applying them to the graph. And once we've done all of that, we click on the red button again and we save the recording. If you don't click browse, it will just save the recording in your personal directory. So now we're going to load another graph. This time we're going to do the mean of wage over occupation instead of industry. And we click the graph editor button, and instead of the red record button, we're going to click the blue play button. And we select the recording we want to apply. And our edits are applied. Edits made using the graph editor are reproducible if you save the file in Stata's graph format, so always save it as a .gph first. To access the graph editor commands, you open the .gph file in a text editor, and we're looking for the .dta dateline. Everything below this line is our code. So we copy it all into a new do file, and then we get rid of the full stop and we put gredit in front instead, and we're then able to apply that in Stata. So this is an example. We've opened our .gph file in Notepad, which is a Windows text editor. And as you can see, there's a lot of information in this graph that comes directly from your data set. So everything that is needed to build the graph in Stata is recorded in the .gph file. So be very careful when sharing these files. If you won't share a data set, don't share a .gph file either. So we find our .dta dateline. We copy all of the commands. And then we open up Stata, and we open a do file. We paste all those commands in. And then we're going to use something called the column mode select. So we hold down the Alt key on our keyboard and drag the cursor. This allows us to type in all of the rows at once, so we can get rid of the full stop and replace it with gredit, and we only have to type it once. So we're now going to load up our NLSW88 dataset again. We're going to run the same graph of mean wage over industry. And then we're going to open up our do file and put the graph next to it so we can see what happens. And then we press the execute button in the do file to apply the edits. And the edits will be applied one by one until you get the graph the same as before. Now you may have noticed that my initial graph did not appear in the traditional Stata colors. It was already customized and without any additional commands or edits. This was actually done using Stata schemes. So I created my own scheme with my chosen defaults. For information on how this works and how to make your own, we do have a tech tip on our website that goes into detail about how to make everything look the way you want. There are a number of places you can find more information about Stata. The Stata cheat sheets are available from our Tech Tips website, and they're a great reference when learning Stata in any of the topics listed here. Our Tech Tips site also showcases useful features in Stata and introductory guides. We also have a graph gallery if you're looking for inspiration, and the Stata YouTube channel and Stata List are great resources to help you get the most out of Stata.